Hello friends, I welcome all of you. In this lecture, I will be doing lab on PIM sparse mode. So you can see that I am using GNS3. There are three routers, R1, R2, R3. Okay, so on these three routers, I will be running multicast routing and sparse mode. There is one video server which will be generating the multicast traffic, okay, and this PC3 it will request for the traffic and it will receive the multicast traffic from video server. So this is a group 239.1.1.100 which I will be using. So what is this sparse mode? Okay, so I'll start with the difference between dense and sparse. We have already done lab on dense mode. In dense mode, we see that there is a fundamental of flood and prune. So whenever traffic comes, it floods, keep on flooding it. Each router will do the same, means each multicast router, until they receive prune message. So it basically consumes a lot of bandwidth in the environment. Okay, and moreover, dense mode is preferred only in small environments, or you can say in those cases where almost all of the subnets or networks want to receive the multicast traffic. So dense mode is not preferred. So alternate is sparse mode, which is widely used. So what it does, it works on the fundamental of pull. Okay, so here traffic will only be sent when there is a request. It is not like dense that it will keep on sending multicast traffic everywhere. It is not like it. So it uses the concept of rendezvous point. This you can call it RP in short form. So what I'll do is I'll configure R2 as rendezvous point. So I'll pick one of the loopback interfaces. We'll configure the IP as 1.1.1.1/32, and then I'll configure command IP PIM RP address, this IP, on all of these three routers. So what is the point of using it? The main benefit is that the traffic, once this video server generates traffic, it will be sent to R2 and then sent to receiver. Okay, but there is a process in between that. So traffic will only be sent when there is a request, and initially it will be sent through RP. Okay, let me take you to this first. So if video server is sending traffic on, let's say, this group 239.1.1.100, it sends traffic to R1. R1 doesn't send it immediately to rendezvous point. Okay, but it will send a PIM register message. Okay, but how does it send it to RP? It basically it knows the RP IP address, this which is present in the unicast routing table, and it finds out the shortest path to reach it. It sends PIM register message to router which is RP, in this case R2. R2 will not reply immediately, but first it will check whether there is a receiver or not, interested party or not. If it doesn't find any receiver, it sends a reject message or stop message, you can say. Okay, stop. So after that, it R1 again sends PIM register message, and R2 will reply the similar behavior, stop, if there is no reply. So in the first message, the PIM register message is encapsulated. Okay, once you open this in Wireshark, you'll find that it's a very simple ICMP packet, but it is encapsulated. So second message and second message onward, whatever messages R1 sent, these will be sent with in the gap of 60 seconds, that is 1 minute. Second message onward, it will be unencapsulated or normal packet. It will not be encapsulated. Okay. Second message will be PIM register message, but it will be type null. So it will be known as PIM register null message. Okay. This is how it goes. Let me delete it. So first message encapsulated register, and second will be register null message, and it will receive stop if there is no demand or no request from anywhere. So once RP receives the request, let's see here. Once PC3 this decides to receive traffic, it sends the IGMP join message to R3. R3 now checks the route for RP, that is rendezvous point 1111. It finds out that this is the shortest path, so it sends a PIM join message to this destination IP multicast group 224.0.0.13. This is a multicast enabled PIM routers. Okay, so every PIM router, PIM enabled multicast router, you can call it. So every PIM router is part of this. So router will receive it, and in this case R2 will receive it. Okay, and after that R2 will send PIM join message to R1. Okay, so basically it will request that R1 should send traffic now. Okay, so this is how traffic will reach. Now let me show you what will be the flow will be like this. Okay, so this is the flow. This is known as RPT, route path tree, because RP rendezvous point is basically a route. Okay, it is managing your topology. That is why it is known as RPT. So it appears that it is not an optimal path to send traffic. Unnecessary, there is a long path being used. But actually, what happens if at any time R3 comes to know, in this case, because it is the one which is sent request, right? It's a requester of PIM join messages. If at any stage R3 comes to know that there is a better route to reach video server or to receive traffic of video server, then what it does, it sends PIM join messages to R1, and R1 will reply saying okay, I will send it through you. After that, what will happen? Flow of traffic will be like this. Okay, so it is the shortest. So RPT means the traffic will flow via RP only for the first time. After that, it will switch to SPT, shortest path tree. So this path, shortest, you know, this is the concept of dense mode. So RPT switches over to SPT. All right. So this shortest path, you can choose to disable it. You can say that I don't want to use it, I just want to keep it using the RP path. Okay, in this case, actually, I have deliberately chosen R2 as RP because it is not optimal. Okay, I wanted to show you how this switch happens. You will see that switch. So this was the theory behind it. I'll just have to configure EIGRP for routing protocol. For advertisement, I have to configure RP, enable multicast routing. IP addressing is already done. So it will be very simple thing to configure sparse mode. Remember it, very simple. It is just that we need to understand it well. Okay, friends. So this is how the sparse mode works. So you can see the diagram. You can see that there are interfaces mentioned there. So friends, the IPs have been pre-configured on all of these 5 devices. Only IP is not configured is 1111. So let me take you to console and we'll do it. I will configure the loopback IP address 1.1.1 to 255255255255. Okay, so now I'll just need to configure the EIGRP. Okay, so commands is router EIGRP 100, network all 0, no auto summary. Just copy and paste it on R2. Let me clean it. R1, R3. Okay, it is done. Now we will enable multicast routing. I will upload this this file. Okay, command to enable multicast routing is IP multicast routing, and we'll configure sparse mode on interfaces. See, all of these three routers are using these three interfaces: F0/0, 1/0, 2/0. So I'm using range command to configure IP PIM sparse mode. Okay, it is only command to enable sparse mode. Okay, so done on R2, done on R1. Okay, now we need to configure rendezvous point. Okay, R2 has already been configured with the 1111 IP. Okay, command to configure rendezvous point is IP PIM RP address. Okay, this is configured. The same command needs to be there on rest of the routers like R1 and R3. So configuration is done, friends. It is very simple. So let me show you one of the interfaces. You can see that it just had to be configured with the command IP PIM sparse mode. Okay, after that we configure the command IP PIM RP address this. Okay, so configuration part is done. Alright. So now I will be doing verification. Okay, so first of all, let's run some commands to verify the PIM sparse mode. Show IP PIM neighbors. Alright, you can see that there are neighbors and it's using version 2. S means sparse mode. Show IP PIM interfaces. So these are all interfaces which are participating in this PIM. Show IP PIM RP. There is one command. Show IP PIM RP. You can even mention the group, then you'll come to know that this is the rendezvous point 1111. Okay, and if you do show IP M route, you will see only the *G. Okay, let me clear this because it's an old entry. Clear IP M route star. Let me clear it on R2 as well. Clear IP M route star. Show IP M route. It doesn't have any *G entry for the group which we will be using, 239.1.100. This entry, this is for auto RP. Okay, so we are not using auto RP right now. So we are actually using static. Okay, so if you do here, show IP M route. Also, you can choose to ignore it right now. Okay, now I'll enable debug IP PIM. Here I'll show you PIM register message and stop messages. Similarly on R2, debug IP PIM. Now I'll generate some traffic from video server towards this group. For this group right now there is no receiver, Let me show you. From here I'm gonna generate traffic. Okay. So R1 will receive traffic and it will send registry messages to R2. It will not send the traffic. So here it is. I'm gonna generate. Now you see. Send V2 register to this IP. It's a register message and it received register stop. It means RP doesn't have any host which is in need of this multicast group traffic. Okay, after 60 seconds you will receive a null register message. So this first packet, it was encapsulated, okay, and it got decapsulated by, it was decapsulated by RP. Similarly, you will see R2, and here you will see received V2 register message. It came from R1 and it replied with stop. Okay, so R2 replied stop, R1 received the stop. Here, these two lines. Now it will send a registered null message. Let's wait for around 60 seconds. See, null register message. Okay, so now onwards null register message will go and it received stop. Okay, so these messages will repeat. It's basically asking the RP, do you need traffic or not? Okay, so now what will I do? I'll put this PC into IGMP group 239.1.1.100. Okay, now you will see complete functionality has changed. So RP will be accepting the traffic, and that is why you will see the replies now. And 3112 is replying, it is a PC3. Let me show you. Show IP interface brief. Okay, so we'll try to understand these messages. R1, let me stop it now. Undebug all. So here it had received stop message. Okay, so after that, the moment I requested PC3 to join the group, it sent messages, join message. It received join message from RP. Okay, RP interface, and in the message there was this IP address 10.1.1. So it is basically accepting the traffic now. All right. So where is my diagram? Traffic flow for the first packet will be like this. After that it will be this, but we cannot see this traffic via RP because it happens for millisecond. But right now I'll show you that it is using SPT. Okay, so I'll go to this R1 and we'll check the M route. Okay, and you will see that the S, G entry for this server will have the incoming interface as F0/0 and outgoing as 2/0. It would mean that traffic is actually going like this. This will be outgoing interface, okay, and this will be incoming. Okay, and this interface, it will not be there in the outgoing. Similarly, on R3, when I will check M route, this one will be the incoming 2/0, outgoing will be F0/0, and this interface, it will be pruned. All right, so let's check R1 first. Undebug all, show IP M route. see this. This is S, G entry, right? S means the video server, and this is the multicast group for which traffic is being sent. Incoming interface F0/0. That's what I said you. Okay. Outgoing will be 2/0. Okay. And here you can see that RPF neighbor is 0000 because it is actually receiving the traffic directly from a host. Okay. And this was the star comma G entry which had the RP1111. It appeared because of request from receiver. Okay, so what I mentioned here, it turned out to be true. Now I'll check R3, this one. Okay, if incoming is 2/0, outgoing is F0/0, it would mean that it is using SPT, shortest path tree. That is not RPT. Let me take you there. R3. Let's check show IP M route. See, incoming 2/0, outgoing 0/0. That's what I said, right? 2/0 and F0/0. And there is no reference of 1/0 because it has been pruned. It has sent a pruned message to R2. For the first time, this one was blocked. After that, it changed. So now this path is used. R1, R2. Let me clean it. Now this path is being used. So if you don't want this RPT to SPT conversion, then you can use one command at R3, because R3 is looking for shortest path. That is why SPT was used. Okay, if you don't want this, then what you can do is there is one command. Let me show you. Configure the command IP PIM SPT threshold. Here you can say that only move to SPT from RPT when threshold is, let's say, 10,000 kbps. It's in kbps. Let me show you. You can define the speed of traffic, or once you do infinity, it means this SPT will never be used. Now it means path has changed. So what will be the path? Now I have disabled SPT. So outgoing incoming will be 0/0 at R1. Outgoing will be 1/0. It will be outgoing. Okay. And at R2, incoming will be 1/0. Outgoing will be 2/0. Okay. See. Okay. 1/0. That's what I was expecting to see 1/0 as outgoing. Now I will check R2. 1/0 incoming, 2/0 outgoing. Okay. So what does it mean? It means the traffic is actually going via RP. Like this. Okay. This is and moreover, you will not see S, G entry at R3 because now it is receiving the traffic via RP. Let me show you. Show IPM route. So it is receiving the traffic via this RP. Okay, on this star comma G entry, you will notice that outgoing interface is 0/0 and incoming is 1/0. This one is incoming and outgoing is 0/0. It means that traffic is going via RP. This is what I wanted to show you. Other than that, if you are having trouble understanding this debug, what you can do is you can right click on this link, start the capture, start the interface, right click, start Wireshark. Okay, so it will start capturing the Wireshark. Friends, I hope that it's been informative to you. Do give me appropriate rating and feedback. Thank you so much.